So I thought I'd do a little quick tour. I don't know if it's gonna be quick, but interior tour of my Peak Glider 389. It's a 2017 glider with a Cat 6NZ engine in it, and it's a long nose Pete. As you can see, that's a long nose out there. That's why they call them long noses. And what I'll just kind of go around here and show you everything I carry in here. Kind of carry a lot of stuff. Let's start here, I guess. Yeah, I got a spinner knob because it helps you back up and turn. Standard dash gauge packages. I've got a right way scale system in here that actually measures the weight on my steer axle, my drive axles on my tractor, and my trailer axles, and then gives me a gross weight. So I always know what I'm carrying as far as the legal limits on all my axles. This little flap here I put on here because at night this screen, yeah, it does adjust up and down the brightness, but in order to see it during the day, you got to have it pretty bright, and it's a pain in the butt to adjust. So I got this little screen I flip over there, so at night it doesn't bother me. Got a dash cam that runs constantly, so if anybody backs into me at night while I'm sleeping, I got a record of it. This is a pre-pass. It's an elite pass from pre-pass. This allows me, the sensors on the road read this particular box. You see scale way stations where you're going down the road. The scale, about a mile before, it reads this sensor. And then you go over sensors in the road and it reads your weight and everything. It also pays my tolls. If I go through toll roads, I don't have to stop. It just bills me automatically. So that's kind of what that's stuck up there for. GPS, obviously. I've got a headset that I use. It's a Blue Tiger Elite headset. By law, you cannot hang on to a phone while you're going down the road. So I got a magnet mount there. Keep it right there so it's always in view. I've got several mounts up here. Hope you can see this. The light's pretty bright outside. For my GoPro and my Sony camera for doing videos. I've got a Galaxy DX 959 CB, 100 watt booster on it. Microphone and mic cord hang from the ceiling up here. I got upper storage. I put a custom shelf in here. This shelf is additional. It allows me to store all kinds of stuff up here. Red, keep my glasses clean. I got extra masks up here. I got another magnet mount. I got a fan here that actually was just there charging. I use this little battery operated fan at night to keep me cool so I don't have to idle the truck some nights because this thing sucks fuel. I got Clorox wipes, another rag, binoculars in case I get into a spot and I'm trying to see where maybe a dock is down the street or something, or a parking lot. This is actually a light that clips onto the bottom of a ball cap. So you got LED lights so you can see if you're working on your truck at night, which is pretty handy. Keep my calendars and books up here. More cameras down here in this box. I got a little deal here. I keep, Tums, cleaner for my glasses, beef jerky, just snacks, stuff that doesn't kill you going down the road. Masks, keep my cab book, which you have to have by law. It's got your license and registration and insurance and everything in here. So when you go through a scale, sometimes they ask you for your cab book. That's what that is. Keep my wallet, hand sanitizer, things down there. That's kind of a little better view of that shelf. You can kind of see how I can store lots of stuff up here. So that's kind of nice. So it might be easier to see back here. There we go, because it's adjusting itself a little bit. So I got cabinets on the left and the right side. On the fridge, I'll show you that in a minute. I put bath mats in my truck because I want to keep my carpets looking brand new all the time. Underneath, I've got bottled water. Power unit for all the equipment inside my truck. I got dish satellite TV. I've got a printer under here. I keep all that under the bunk. Pretty easy to get to. Obviously, I got a TV back here. I've got a sound bar mounted underneath the TV so I can hear the TV really well. I've got a microwave up here. Works really well. I got extra camera mounts and A clamps and stuff I keep around here. Down here is an extra shelf. I just keep coffee. Actually, when I go to bed at night, I take this coffee maker back here. I got a little Mr. Coffee maker. Plugs into this light strip, which is plugged into the power unit under the seat. I'll put the coffee maker here, have the water, coffee in it, all ready to go. So when I get up in the morning, I don't even have to get out of bed. I've got a switch mounted over here. I hit that button and it turns on the power to the coffee maker. So coffee's brewing while I'm waking up. So obviously the control units and everything. These are lights that I added after the fact. I just wanted under cabinet lights. Those work really well. Got another container back here with Clorox wipes, fuel filter because my cabinet's full. You know, just all kinds of stuff back here. So what I did, these Peterbilts come with, if you order it custom, you can get, there's this cabinet on the top up here and the one on the right. They make it where there's a cabinet that goes across the back too. But this one was already built, so I didn't have that option. Peterbilt and PACCAR are a pain in the ass to try to just buy that cabinet. They charge you an engineering fee and all kinds of stupid shit. I don't deal with that, but so there's limited cabinet space in here. So what I did was, because I cook a lot in my truck, I took and put these cabinets in here. It actually, these are just plastic cabinets you can buy at Walmart. And I keep all my silverware, spices, you know, all kinds of things in here. And then I've got paper bowls, coffee, canned goods, coffee, blah, blah, blah. I keep down here just odds and ends stuff, Pam, more canned stuff. Just odds and ends stuff. And the bottom drawer is all soups and things like that. Oops, sorry about the camera there. And then these cabinet doors have built-in shelves in them. Now on the other side, it's a clothes closet. So I hang all my clothes up in there, dryer sheets, electronic stuff, batteries, all that kind of good stuff. And then the fridge, it's an okay size fridge. But, you know, I carry a lot of meats and cheeses and hard-boiled eggs and some Gatorade sodas. The top of the freezer's empty right now. I got a Coke getting ice cold in there because I just sounded good. So you got to kind of plan your day accordingly when your trip accordingly during the week to make sure you got everything. Got my camera bag and then a duffel bag. Cabinets over here. I keep jeans and special shirts. Some places you have to have safety shirts on or long-sleeve shirts. Keep a hard hat up here because it's steel places. You got to have a hard hat and a safety vest. But that's kind of it. You know, there's upper cabinets up here as well. I'm trying to think if I'm missing anything here. I don't think I am. I do have one thing that's kind of handy. This thing here is actually made to hang on the front of your seat. It's got all these pockets in there and it just hangs. It's made to hang on the front of the seat up here. But I didn't want all that stuff up here, so I just reversed it and hang it behind the passenger seat so that everything stays nice and clean. I don't like clutter in my truck. Even though there's a lot of stuff here, you will see guys going down the road with all kinds of shit piled up on their dashboard. And it just blows my mind because if you have to do anything fast in traffic, yeah, that stuff's not glued down. It's gonna go flying around your cab. Oh, and the other thing I carry with me is a Verizon data dongle. Just a little bitty thing. It's called a MiFi. You have to log in sometimes to go to the load board to book a load. That dongle allows me internet access almost anywhere. Now, a lot of people will tie up. They'll use the hotspot on their phone. Problem is, you use too much data on your phone, and it starts throttling your data, and everything slows down. I don't like using that because it just eats up your data, and then you can't get, when you're online, especially when you're trying to book a load, speed is money. If you take too long online on your phone or whatever you're doing to book a load, by the time you call them, it'll be gone. I mean, there's 100 trucks in an area trying to get 5 loads. And so you got to be quick. So that data dongle is important for me. But that's kind of it. That's the interior of my truck. Really, that's about all there is to it. I hope you enjoyed it. I'd show you more on the outside, but you've probably seen it in other videos, and I'm sure you get tired of seeing it. But anyway, that's it for the inside. Hope you enjoyed it. Drop me a comment if you got any questions about stuff I use or how I wired things up. Inverter, a power inverter. That's the word I was looking for that thing down under the seat that where provides all the power for my TV and everything. So that's it. So I will talk to you soon. Take care.